Hey folks, it's me, Bittersteel, back with another video for Hearts of Iron 4. Now today I have for you a Northern Light. As a Scandinavian country, we have to form our own faction and include Denmark, Sweden, Norway and Finland. So let's get cracking. But first, if you like these videos, leave a like, consider subscribing for more of this content, and don't forget to click the bell icon to be notified whenever I upload new videos. Also, feel free to check out my Twitter. I post some funny memes there and updates on the channel, as well as check out our Discord. We've set up a nice little community. I'll leave links to both Twitter and Discord down in the video description below. Now, on to the video. Now we can do this as any of the four Nordic countries. Let's start out with Sweden, arguably the strongest of the Nordics. Let's put it on Iron Man, historical focuses on, and start the game. Here we are. Now, before we do anything, we're gonna create an intelligence agency. Much will hinge on this intelligence agency, so we'll start with it right away. Next up, the military. We will disband the entire military. All of them can go. Military factories. What we'll be producing is infantry equipment, a little bit of artillery, and guns. Yes, that will do for now. We'll prioritize the guns and then fill up with towed artillery and support equipment. Research is very generic, nothing fancy here. It's just your basic industry, and then you follow up with infantry equipment or whatever direction you want to go. Maybe get some planes, get some better submarines, if you want to turn this into a full-fledged run. For the purposes of the guide, the research is almost entirely irrelevant. Construction. We'll just build a few more military factories in our high development provinces. And for focuses, we'll start out with political effort, getting us a nice chunk of political power. And with all that setup done, let's put the speed to maximum and get going.
3 days later.
And with the creation of our intel agency, we can start work on the actual meat and potatoes of this guide. We will be upgrading our agency 5 times. That will allow us to have 2 espionage slots. A good ones to pick would be psychological warfare. Boost ideology and propaganda missions are very nice, especially for the purposes of the guide. Other ones that are these unfortunate pills here. The invisible ink is pretty nice. Commando training, not bad. And then pick whichever you like if you want to turn this into a full-fledged run. It doesn't really matter. Just get the important ones that I just mentioned and then fill it out until you get to 5. Once we have 5 upgrades done for the intel agency, we'll have 2 spies. And for our first spy, we have 2 decent options. The seducer, not bad. And the natural orator. Very good for our future uses, so I'll go with the orator. We will send our first spy to Finland to build an intel network. The reason why we need 2 spies for this is quite simple. We need 1 spy to maintain the intel network at maximum efficiency, while the second spy will simply start using propaganda to push Finland's stability down and boost party ideology to get their fascist support up. We need to get fascism support above 20% and their stability below 70%. That way we can stage a coup in Finland. But you'll see that later on. And with political effort done, we have a nice batch of political power. And our first investment will be the fascist demagogue. Now, we cannot continue down the collectivist tree yet because we lack the fascism support. So I suggest taking the industrial effort and getting some military and civilian factories. We will now wait for 10% support for the NSAP, after which we can prepare for civil conflict.
3 weeks later.
There we go. We now have more than 10% support for the NSAP, and we can prepare for civil conflict. We will be using expand civil support quite a lot until we are below 50% stability, at which point we can ignite our civil conflict. We will not be bothering with any of these other options. We will simply be spamming this one until we are ready to launch our conflict. We now have 5 upgrades for the intelligence agency. These are the ones I've chosen. And in 28 days, we will have our 2nd operative. We will stick him on Finland and he can do his thing there. Ooh, we have a nice operative to choose here. So I'll take the best one and we will stick this one on Finland. And for the time being, she can do a propaganda. Once we turn fascist, we will be boosting ideology until we get to around 20%. A little more, just I'll be on the safe side. There we go. Our stability is low enough that we can ignite our civil conflict. So let's get right on that. Click the button. And you'll see, due to our extensive increase in civilian support, our enemy does not get a lot of territory. Usually they just get this little bit down here in Scania. The rest has already fallen to us. It's going to be easy to win this one. We'll simply train up as many of these cavalry divisions as we can. Obviously, not a lot. We are quite short on equipment. We'll place them down as close to the border as possible, within reach of both victory points, but I believe Malmö will be enough. High priority, and we will immediately deploy them once they are available. Furthermore, we will not be spending any more political power until we have 190 PP in our bank. As for research, now that the industry techs are starting to finish and be caught up on time, now is a good idea to start investing in the military now. We will be fighting a few wars soon-ish. Our units are ready to deploy and we'll immediately put them down. 5 cavalry divisions. Not great, not terrible. Send half to Malmö and send a few here to Karlskrona. And that saw the civil conflict resolved rather quickly. We'll now take all of these horses, assign them a general, and park them on the Norwegian border. We'll also train a few more. Single run of, let's see, 19 cavalry divisions. That should fill out one army. Should be enough to deal with Norway. As for production, it's coming along nicely. More factories are starting to finish from our tree. We'll be getting more from armament effort, and we'll also be building several more ourselves. Now that we are finally a fascist nation, it's a good time to change one of our spies over from propaganda efforts to ideology boosting. While you may be tempted to take the rebuild the nation decision here, I recommend against it. It will take 365 political power. It's a full year where we will not be gaining any political power, and we need quite a bit more to be able to do our justifications. As for the navy, Sweden starts with a relatively large navy. Just park them all in our port near the Danish belts. I believe Göteborg, just park them all here. We'll be using them for a bit of naval invading later on. As you can see, manpower is starting to be a concern, especially because not only do we need to finish these cavalry divisions, we'll also need quite a few of these infantry divisions later on to deal with our other enemy, Denmark. Fortunately, as a fascist nation, we have access to the collectivist ethos branch of the standard focus tree. This one holds a few decent focuses, giving us a more recruitable population. So once we finish armament effort, we'll be heading down towards military youth and eventually paramilitarism and ideological fanaticism to be able to create factions. There we go, we have 190 PP. Time for a little bit of cheese. We'll start out with Denmark. Select Denmark and justify a war goal, any one state, and you'll see it take 240 days. That's great. Now for Norway, do the same, any state will do, and you'll see this is 355 days. That's a rather large gap, leaving time for the allies to start doing things with their guarantees. Not perfect. What we can do is go back to Denmark, cancel our justification, and just start over. As you can see, this one now also takes 355 days, meaning for exactly 190 political power, we will be able to finish these two justifications simultaneously. We can declare our war at the same time without allied involvement. That's pretty great. As for Finland, well, you have to wait and see what our plan is for Finland. Now, we've got a good deal of factories out of the standard focus tree already, but it's time to get some manpower, so we'll be heading down towards military youth. As for any additional political power past this point, a good pick is always going to be the silent workhorse. The earlier you get him, the bigger the gain he will provide, as well as limited conscription, extra manpower. We're not a very populous nation. And then the usual partial mobilization or war economy and military stuff. The rest, I leave up to you. Now, our spies in Finland have been doing an excellent job. Fascist support is 23%. I think it's time to switch over to something else. We can go back to propaganda efforts and destabilize the country, working on getting this stability below 70%. Why 70%, you ask? Well, it's simple. In order to orchestrate a coup, we need 20% support for our chosen political leaning, as well as less than 70% stability. Now, these events are rather unfortunate, but they're bound to happen. No worries, we have enough time to continuously rescue our captives and still complete the mission. You might want to set operations to a high priority to ensure the supplies actually reach the spies quickly. Now, there's no harm in rushing some of these units out the door. If you notice, the justification period is almost up. It's important that we get those troops on the front lines. And a little bit more manpower won't hurt. We'll assign the infantry with a new general. I have to hire a new guy. 3 of them can perform a naval invasion from Göteborg and hit Odense or Odense. And we'll leave 1 or 2 here on the border with Copenhagen. The idea will be to cut them off and attack Copenhagen from both sides, quickly knocking the Danes out of this. 2 units on Copenhagen seems fine. The rest can make this naval invasion here. and the navy can be set to naval invasion support in the Danish belts. That should be more than sufficient. The Danish navy is not particularly large. As for our Norwegian front, we have that rather well covered with a bunch of cavalry divisions. We cannot beat these Norwegian troops fairly, so we won't fight them fairly. We have way more troops than them, so we'll simply be running around behind them, rushing victory points, encircling their divisions, and keeping them pinned down as much as we can, while we simply destroy their country with mobile warfare. As for Finland, as you can see, our spies have done an excellent job. We have more than 20% fascism support. Their current stability is below 70%, which means we can now orchestrate a coup. Let's prepare that as well. Use both agents. We'll need 9,000 infantry equipment for this, so it would not be a bad idea to designate some equipment for this. Commence when ready. And as our target, very important here, we will target the province of Åland, or Åland, whatever that is in Finnish. Why this tiny little island? It's quite simple, really. The coup will start with a relatively large amount of divisions, all stacked on that single port, which means it's virtually impossible for Finland to naval invade that, meaning the coup will survive long enough for us to invite them into our faction and complete the achievement. Now, I realize that simply adding this tiny little island to our faction is a little bit cheesy, but there's other advantages as well. While the civil conflict between those two parts is going on and world tension rises, we'll be able to invite the fascist part to our faction. Great. What will also happen is the USSR will do its thing and start the Winter War if the Finns refuse to hand over Karelia. If that happens, the Soviets will capitulate Finland without much issue, and instead of taking all of the stuff that they were going to take, everything will simply be flipped to the fascists, because that's how civil wars work, and we'll add a relatively strong fascist Finland to our faction if we want to continue this run. So let's start work on that. Now, war with our neighbors is quite close. We're about 30 days off, 1 month. Provided we have the equipment, which we currently don't really have, we could change up this template, the basic infantry template, into something a little more robust. Add an infantry unit and two artillery units, and voila, we now have a standard 7-2 division. There we go, both justifications finish at the same time. Now we will simply declare these wars individually. As you can see, no guarantee here. Simply declare. No guarantee here either, and we'll declare this war as well. Two wars for the price of one. As for Denmark, we simply set off our naval invasion, envelop Copenhagen, and destroy the units there, then take the rest of the country if they haven't capitulated already. Now for Norway, a little bit trickier. We will be using extensive maneuver warfare to simply worm our way to all of their southern victory points, encircle as many divisions as we can, pin them down, and then take whatever we need to capitulate them in the end. By that time, we can also use our Danish army to come help break up whatever they have left. So let's take the speed way, way down and get this done. You may need to use a few of these force attack decisions if they're guarding this port particularly well, but in the end, should be able to take it. And that's the Danes dealt with relatively easily. Take all of their states. Now at this point, should you have any trouble with Norway, they are quite large and you need almost all of their victory points, Now is a good time to simply swing those relatively experienced units from the Danish campaign over to Norway and finish the job.
12 seconds later.
Good equipment from Norway. And we'll simply take all their states as well. So, that's one chunky Sweden already. Fun fact, we can now restore the Kalmar Union, but that's not the purpose of this video. We can still do that later on should you want to continue this run. First things first, let's head to occupied territories and start releasing some puppets. Norway can be our puppet, and Denmark can be our puppet. So we now have the Norges Velvet and the North Sea Empire. So that's just Finland left. Now, we're rather unfortunate, once again, that they captured another one of our operatives. Yes, we were so close to getting the required equipment, and that doesn't matter, we can still get it done. Now, with these two puppets already secured, that's all the wars we're going to fight for the purpose of the achievement. If you want to continue this run, I suggest cranking out a lot more artillery, infantry equipment, and maybe some planes, some support equipment, naturally. And shoring up this southern border with the Germans. They might get funny ideas of invading Denmark and Norway. Same with your Finnish border. Best be ready for those Reds, boys. There we go. We're now orchestrating our coup. A little later than we would have liked, but we still finished before the end of 38. So well ahead of those nasty winter wars the Soviets like to do. There we go. Unfortunately, an agent was forced into hiding. That doesn't matter. Our plan worked. We now have a small fascist uprising on the island of Åland at war with the rest of Finland, and Finland can't touch them. What we're going to do now is start diplomatic relations with Greater Finland. We will improve our relations with them, and we'll also send our agents over to apply some diplomatic pressure, making them a little more receptive to our advances. Let's see here. Create faction. Well, we're a little ways off, but as world tension climbs and their opinion of us rises, not to mention the work our spies will do, they will eventually accept, and we will have all of the Nordic countries in our faction for the achievement.
1 eternity later.
There we go. Germany has started World War II. A nice little spike in world tension. See if the Finns are more amenable to our advances. Yes, they are. Now create a faction with them. We'll obviously name that Northern Light. Send the invitation. Dawn of the Northern Light. Excellent. Let's check the faction map mode. And the faction Northern Light now includes Denmark, Norway, Sweden, and yes, this counts as Finland for the achievement. Now if you want to sit and wait a little, the Soviet Union will start their winter offensive soon-ish. And they might just take care of this problem for us. If they don't, well, we'll simply have to justify a war goal ourselves and mop this up. Because it will take quite a while to reach that 50% world tension to join the war, and them being a fascist nation, they're not very interested in us joining the war, unfortunately. I hope you liked this video. It's a little bit shorter than my usual ones, but I still had a bit of fun with it, especially playing around with the spies, a very La Resistance feature. So this is how you get the Northern Light achievement in 1.9.3 with La Resistance enabled. If you liked it, leave a like, hit me up in the comments with more of your suggestions for future videos, some challenges, some achievements you want to see, and consider subscribing to see more of this content. If you didn't like it, that's fine, just hit that dislike button. Hit me up in the comments and tell me what I did wrong. I'm always looking to learn. This has been me, Bitter Steel. Have a good one.